Welcome to DIYTryin.
Strap lasers to something new.
I'm Patty Norton.
I'm Michael Head.
What are we doing?
So this week I'm really excited. We're gonna be sending music through the air wirelessly using laser beams.
I gotta say, this is one of the coolest things I think we've ever done. And this is a science project that you've always wanted to do.
Yeah, so I saw this project years ago and I always thought that it would be really difficult to do, so I never actually attempted it. But then I went back and looked and it looks pretty easy.
After what, 14 episodes of DIYTryin, suddenly anything is within Michael's reach. This is a show about empowerment. And this week it's a show about lasers.
Lasers.
And breaking them, but we'll explain that in a minute. So here's what you're gonna need, a laser. You can get them off of eBay, you can get them from your local pet store, a couple of batteries, audio connectors, an audio transformer from Radio Shack, and a photo resistor.
Yeah, so I'm excited to try this out because it's coming from a site that I loved growing up. It's called sci-toys.com. And it's just a site that has tons of little projects that you can do. They're not necessarily geared towards kids, but kids can do a lot of them.
Case in point, the missing shed in your parents' backyard that they still haven't figured out why it's gone.
May have blown a few things up using hydrogen bombs. Not really, because I'm not a nuclear physicist.
Young man's got to do what a young man's got to do. Do your parents watch the show?
I really hope not.
they know
never
about the
found
shed.
Out what happens in that shed.
This project is super simple. Connect the leads from a 3.5 millimeter jack to the audio transformer input connection. That's the side with two wires. On the output side, connect your positive battery lead to the blue wire. The green wire will connect to the positive lead in your laser. And finally, the negative lead connects to the negative side of your laser. And that's it for the transmitter. You're gonna have an extra black wire from the transformer. Ignore it, it is of no consequence. SciToys author does suggest to connect a bicolor LED in line with the transformer outputs to prevent voltage spikes that'll kill your laser, but we were living dangerously when we started this project until it got expensive.
On the receiving side, it's even easier. You just get a battery and a 3.5 millimeter jack, and you kind of just put the photoresistor in line with the
way you make a circuit.
Yeah, you just
make
a series circuit. And that's pretty much all we're gonna need to do. So let's assemble this all together in a nice little package and then we'll try it out.
Brace yourselves, people.
Trying to hit Run Pauline. I love this song. And it's gone. And it's gone. And it's gone.
It's lasers. Rap?
Trip hop?
Hip hop, yes.
So he's listening to music using a laser beam and a shark. So my favorite thing about this is you can actually see the laser modulating as the sound gets louder.
So the laser is doing, basically we're amplitude modulation or AM, like as in radio. So we're varying the strength against the carrier and it's kind of trippy. It also doesn't work very well in really bright rooms, we've discovered.
No, so the room that we're in is just a huge window in front of us.
Yeah.
So the laser looks pretty dim at this point. So it seems to be messing with the photoresistor as well so that the volume is still pretty decent in headphones, but when we hook it up to the amp, you can't really hear it.
No, well that's kind of an impedance mismatch on that end, but we had this downstairs going like 35, 40 feet across the room, and as soon as we came up here with the wall of glass death, we got like 18 to 20 inches started to be our maximum.
Yeah.
You know, on one sense, this is not gonna replace like a standard copper cable. You're not gonna be like, I'm gonna use lasers to rig up my household stereo equipment. But this is a really fun experiment. It also got to be kind of an expensive one because it turns out if you turn the volume up too high, as you get your amplitude modulation on and you boost things up, we think we managed to burn out six lasers this morning. Yeah.
So, because the transformer is adding voltage to the signal that you're or the voltage that you're already sending with the batteries, it can boost it up quite a bit.
Yeah, apparently quite a bit enough to make for like two round trips to the pet store, and I'm starting to get funny looks like, what
are you doing with all the lasers?
So apparently lasers don't like being overdriven.
Right. So that could get a little expensive. So I'm kind of over the entire laser experimentation experience. But Mr. Hand, you are obsessed.
I love lasers, they're so cool. I wanna combine all the broken ones that we have into like a single beam and try to do laser hair removal because I hate shaving, it's too expensive.
This is starting to sound like a backstory in one of the more peculiar episodes of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
It'll work.
Famous last words, Harvey. I'm making a Two-Face reference for the scarring that's gonna happen. Michael needs to know about our sponsor, dollarshaveclub.com/DIY. They will send delightful razors, high quality razors for like $1 a month. For like $9 a month, you get like the $4,000 razors that they keep behind lock and key at your local store, except they show up in your mailbox to your home automatically for practically no money. You will look better and you will thank us for telling you about dollarshaveclub.com/DIY.
That does sound mighty convenient.
You know, compared to lasing your face off.
I'm still gonna take apart a CD burner and try it out, but.
To lase what?
I'll start with my arm and go from there.
While Michael searches for a new career at home depilatory and starts moving down to Southern California where everybody wants to be lased clean, this is just a frightening image even for me to have inside of my head. I'm just gonna say thank you for watching, and I hope we haven't completely turned you off from the show. DIYTryin.com if you're on the internet. YouTube.com/DIYTryin is a place to subscribe if you are on the YouTubes.
Or if you wanna send us messages, DIYTryin@revision3.com or @DIYTryin on Twitter.
I would like to appeal to each and every one of you personally to send a tweet at Palm Daily and saying, Michael, please don't laze your face off.
Nope, not listening.
I'm afraid.
I might not be back next week, though.
I don't like that thought. I'm Patrick Norton.
I'm Michael Hand.
We'll see you next week on DIYTryin.
You didn't answer that question. Did you ever burn your parents' house down?
More of a shed in the backyard.
All right, do me a favor.
Yes.
Try one of those. That's the spirit.